Hello, everyone, and welcome to News and Views for September the 19th, 2024. We have a jam-packed show for you today, so I'm going to try and make this short and sweet for you. But before I go into it, I do want to bring your attention to two events that are happening this weekend. So if you're seeing this early enough, you might be able to catch those. Tomorrow, which is Friday, the seniors consultation with our MLA Jody Byram is happening at 1 p.m. This is happening at the Yellowhead. The Titans season opener is happening this Saturday. So the Titans season kicks off for real this Saturday. I should mention the senior consultation, Yellowhead Manor, not Yellowhead Hall. So those are two events happening this weekend that you should check out if you're able. If you can't get the seniors consultation, it will be airing on the station on Monday and several other times throughout the next couple of weeks. So on to the show for today. Kicking off with Fuel Good Day at the Co-op. This is an annual event that the co-ops do. This year, raising money for Habitat for Humanity in Neepawa. Then we were down at Country Meadows for Annie Dobish's 110th birthday. So that is not very often you get to celebrate an 110th birthday with someone. By all accounts, a good time had by all. Next, we are down to close to Park Lake, where they are doing some tree planting. This was sponsored by Home Hardware. And the trees were purchased through Tree Canada, which is a nonprofit. So good things happening all around down there. Next, we have the kickoff for Legion Week. So there was a ceremony down at the Cenotaph this past weekend for that. And Legion Week, of course, continues through this week. Then we were out at Neepawa's first Pride celebration. Neepawa's Got Pride. That was happening again this past Saturday afternoon. So we have a short of that on the show today. Full version elsewhere in our schedule later on in the next couple of weeks. Same for the Walk With Me for Down Syndrome. That happened out at the Langford Trail, again on Saturday afternoon. So we have a clip of that for you here today. Again, longer version later in our schedule. And same thing for the Terry Fox Run, the annual run that happens. A short interview and a bit of clip of the Terry Fox Run, and we have the full thing elsewhere in the NACTV schedule. And there could have been more had we enough room this week. So certainly a full week for events in Neepawa. If you have anything coming up, anything you know about, anything you think we should know about, please do get in touch with us. Number is 204-476-2639 or nactv@wcgwave.ca. Thanks and enjoy the show. We're here today with Dawn Wamsley, who's speaking on behalf of Neepawa Chapter of Habitat for Humanity, the recipients of proceeds from this year's Feel Good Day in Neepawa. How did this come about?
Well, I mean, it's a natural evolution, really. I mean, the Habitat for Humanity Committee, the Neepawa branch, just hit the road running. And it's got a good group of people at the core. Community is very engaged, and so something like this is just a natural segue into how the community bands together for a worthwhile cause, and something like this is. And so co-op, we've noted, it's got a long history of helping out the community. Being able to use the Fuel Good Day is a wonderful bonus for us, because we're always looking for donations and things that help as we move towards getting our projects in the road. We have a selection committee in process, currently viewing some applications. It's just all around a good thing, and it's great to see people. People you know, people you don't know.
Yeah.
We've had a lovely group of people come in, passing through, heading, one just did 16,000 kilometer trip down to the States and around Canada.
Wow.
And heading back home again. Yeah. So you have all these kind of neat little stories and a chance for a 3-minute conversation. And it's all good.
And so there's three streams of fundraising here today, I guess, from fueling up, as
yes.
the name of the day
yes.
is.
Yes.
I think 10 cents from every liter is going.
Yeah, that's wild.
And then, of course, there's a barbecue out
yeah.
here.
Yeah.
And I think also there's some money from some drinks sold
yes.
that are happening as well. So
yes, it's just, I mean, every little bit helps. And the nice thing is we've got people who volunteer. And that's part of the neat thing about Habitat for Humanity. You don't need to sign up for a long-term thing. if you want to sit and sit at a table and take 50-50 tickets, or you want to hammer and nails for 2 hours, or you want to be in for the long haul and help with something else, there's a place for everybody. So from the littlest person to the oldest person, to even cantankerous people like me.
Different skill sets.
And so it's really a great cause. And we're really excited to be able to start this process.
And it really only even started to launch late last year.
Yes.
How far along are things now?
Actually moving quite along. We've had a selection recruitment. We are currently looking at a number of applications to narrow it down and look at selection. The crew, John Lavich, for example, really focused in terms of starting to do fundraising and getting trades together. We have a wonderful feedback from everybody within the community and around the area, willing to contribute in some way. So it's one of those real feel-good projects.
That's fantastic, and good luck with everything today.
Thank you very much. We're really pleased with the response so far. Hot dogs have been going like crazy.
Excellent. I need to get one myself right away.
There you go.
Can you see that, Baba? Happy birthday. Happy 110th birthday.
Born in 1914.
Can you smile? You smile for Connie. We'll get you a piece, Annie, okay? You get the first piece and the biggest piece.
Welcome, everybody. Thank you for coming. My name is Ken Fosty, and I'm proud to represent Tree Canada. Tree Canada is Canada's leading tree planting agency, and we are committed to planting trees for future generations to enjoy. Since 1992, Tree Canada has planted over 85 million trees across Canada. We've greened 800 school grounds and helped over 800 communities and municipalities establish permanent tree cover with wonderful partners like Home Hardware. I am pleased to be here today to recognize a grant of $3,800 for tree planting efforts from Nipawa Home Hardware Building Center. Home Hardware is one of Tree Canada's oldest sponsors. Since our partnership began over 32 years ago, we have planted over 34,000 trees, and Home Hardware has contributed well over $1 million across Canada towards tree planting efforts. This year, 26 Home Hardware stores across Canada are participating in tree planting events. The trees we're planting here today will provide multiple benefits, including shade, shelter, aesthetic beauty, recreational benefits, wildlife habitat, as well as clean air. On behalf of Tree Canada, I would like to thank Nipawa Home Hardware Building Center and the town of Nipawa for making this planting event possible. Thank you very much.
How many is it total? 10 or 12? Or?
Oh no, it was $3,800 worth, and I want to say there were between the evergreens I probably had As long as it snows on Christmas Eve, that's fine.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, it's no very business.
I want to see snow like next week.
Skidooer.
I got a skid steer and a paper.
Everyone can smile. It's okay. Yeah.
Sorry, I'll just get everybody looking right here for the first one, right here.
Today's events. To begin, on behalf of Nipawin Area of Pride, we respectfully acknowledge we are gathered on Treaty 2 territory and the ancestral lands of Anishinaabe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, and Dene's people, and the national homeland of Red River Métis. Today is a milestone for Nipaw and the 2S LGBTQIA+ people that call this area home. Together, we are making ourselves visible and showing true pride in ourselves and community. We are making a point to take up space that we have so often left unoccupied. For anyone who has not felt seen, we see you, we are you, and we are going to do this together. Today, we share pride with our families, our friends, and our allies. We are so excited to have this opportunity to create an environment where all people are welcome and celebrated for who they are. To our allies, your active participation in allyship, whether that be wearing pride, standing up for your family member or for friend, or even just working to understand more about the 2S LGBTQIA community. The work and effort you put in is so important to us and vital to creating a safe and healthy community. We'd like to send a huge thank you to our sponsors who have supported our initiatives this year, including Manitoba Pride Alliance, Arts Forward, Pyramid Collision, Nipawin Gladstone Co-op, Nipawin Safeway, Nipawin Veterinary Clinic, Nipawin Home Hardware, Public Servants Alliance of Canada, Inspire Studios, Nipawin Super Thrifty, Mullen Sky, Jennifer Davy Aesthetics, Nipawin Bahagari, and the Town of Nipawin. Special shout out to the Nipawin Public Library, who has provided a safe place for us to meet throughout the year. Thank you to all our amazing volunteers who have helped us along the way, and in particular today. The fact is that we could not have brought Pride to Nipawin without you all. So thank you, and happy Pride.
Thank you.
Happy Pride Nipawin. Oh my God, this is fantastic. Look at you. Look at you. 10 years ago, it's amazing the difference a decade can make. If they had had Pride here 10 years ago, I would still be a Nipawin resident. So it's been a decade since I lived here, and I'm getting older. I turned 60 last year, and to celebrate, I had cataract surgery, because that's what people that are 60 do. So it's amazing, I can actually see everybody and I don't need glasses now. But I started thinking about birthdays and childhood birthdays, and you know, a birthday when you're 60 is no big deal. It's just another day. You go for coffee with your friends, it's nothing. When you're a child, birthdays were so much more fun. You know, they were deadly, but they were more fun. When I was a child, we had money in our birthday cakes, like coins in our birthday cakes, right? Some of you older people are gonna remember that. Because apparently, as children in the 60s, we were expendable. Oh, you choked to death on a quarter. All right, well, y'all just have another child. Right. And those that did not choke to death on a coin in your cake got sent to play with lawn darts in the backyard. I still have our lawn dart set. I picked them up after my parents passed away. They had them in storage. I take them to the park now to see how many young parents I can freak out with this. It's fun. I'm evil. But the birthday presents back when we were children were different, right? Back when I was a child, my favorite present of all was a birthday card with cash in it. That was a perfect grandmother. Every year, my grandmother would give me a card that had cash in it. And it was always a $2 bill, because I'm old and we didn't have toonies and gift cards back then. But it was a $2 bill, and she'd shuffle up to me and she'd hand me my birthday card. And she'd say, "Happy birthday, sweetie. Now don't go spending it all in one place." I won't, Grandma. She didn't know that I had a gambling habit as a toddler. So I loved getting the money because it paid my debts. And she did this every year until I turned 13. 13th birthday, everything changed. Everything changed. She shuffles up and she hands me my birthday card. And she goes, "Happy birthday, sweetie. Don't go spending it all in one place." She never did figure out the gambling issue. So I open the card up. There's $10 in this card. $10. Doesn't sound like much today, but you got to remember, I turned 13 in 1976. $10 to buy a half ounce of killer weed. Thank you, Grandma. Oh, my birthday party is going to be killer tonight. I went to put the money in my pocket, and I realized it's Canadian Tire money. Don't spend it all in one place. Kind of tied my hands on this one, old woman. Now I gotta find a dealer at a Canadian Tire store.
Thank you. Hi, we have here Will Cox, and this is our fifth year, right, for the walk for Down syndrome, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And then I've heard that this year's donation will be given directly to the Touchwood Park. So tell us about this, Will.
So this year we thought we'd donate to something more local, and Touchwood's in need of a little help with their new playground they have, so we thought that'd be a great cause.
Ayun kay init para na si ano ba?
Sounds good.
My name is Sammy Uyevato, and I am from Ipoh here. And just recently, I found out that I have a cancer called osteosarcoma. We figured it out when I broke my arm, the humerus, when I fell off a bike on June 30th. And went to emergency at the hospital here, and later on found out that I had osteosarcoma. And so it's been a lot of time spent at the Health Science Center in Winnipeg. Had to go through multiple tests like a CT and an MRI and much more to find out about the osteosarcoma. And pretty recently. I just started chemo there, has been going to the children's ward there, and I've been very back and forth in Winnipeg, and started going to school here now that school has started.
To the friend.
Two, one, let him go.